Hey guys, I'm just going to show you a really easy tutorial on how to use the Wii Remote and Nunchuck to play Dead Trigger. And I know there's a lot of tutorials out there that show how to use the Classic Controller and the PS3 controller, but if you're like me and your computer's a piece of crap and you can't hook up your PS3 controller, or you don't have a Classic Controller and you just have Wii Remote and Nunchuck, then this would be helpful for you. So you're going to need the app Wii Remote Controller, which is free in the App Store, or Play Store, whatever it's called, whatever you want to call it. And then you'll see at the top of the screen here, it says Init and Connect, and you're going to want to press that, and then after you press it on the Wii Remote, you're going to want to hit the 1 and 2 buttons at the same exact time. And then when it finds the Wii Remote, it'll say done pulling button data, nunchuck was plugged in WM1. So you'll just use that. And then to set up the controls for Dead Trigger, you want to go hit the menu button on your Android and hit preferences. And by the way guys, I'm not sure if this is for root only because I rooted my phone as soon as I got it, but it might be for root only, and I know this doesn't work on all phones. And it does not work on Android 4.2 or above. So if you're on that, then you're out of luck. Anyway, to set for Dead Trigger, you want to go to the menu, preferences, and mapping options. And I already have this set up. So on your Wii Remote, you want to set the up button for D-pad right, XP D-pad right. You want to set down to D-pad left, XP D-pad left. Left to D-pad up, XP D-pad up. And right to D-pad down, XP D-pad down. I don't know why it's set up so weird and up isn't up and left isn't left or whatever, but that's just how it is, and that's how you set that up. So you want A to be number 7. Number 7 means reload. That's what the reload signal or whatever that would be is. So A on the Wiimote will be reload. And let's see, B you want to set to number 6. This will be to aim down the sights in Dead Trigger. 1 will be set to number 3, the 1 button. And this will be to use item number 1. 2 will be set to number 1, which will be item number 2. Plus will be set to back XP 0. This will just be pause in Dead Trigger. It should be. I haven't paused Dead Trigger yet. You don't want to do anything with minus or home. And then on the, what's it called, the nunchuck, you're going to want to set it to letter I. You're going to want to set down on the nunchuck to K. Left to J. And right to L. This is for the camera controls in Dead Trigger, so you can look around. And what we did up here, this was for moving around and walking. Okay, C, you want to set to number 8. This is how you shoot. And Z, you want to set to A, which is switch weapons. Now this is my setup. You can rearrange the buttons to however you want to set them up, but that's just how I use it. And then here's Classic Controller settings, which if you're watching this, you most likely don't have one, or you don't like using it, so that you won't need. And then you're going to want to save as profile, and I usually just, when I saved this, I named it Dead Trigger, just so it would be easy. And then if you ever need to load it for some reason into another controller mapping, you load from profile and you just pick this one, or whatever one you previously named it. And now I will show you the Dead Trigger gameplay using the Wiimote controls. Okay, now I don't know how to set up the menus and stuff to work with the Wii Remote. yet, so you'll still have to use the touchscreen for that, you know, to load missions and quests and stuff. But in-game, you just, you know, it's very easy. And I just realized that I forgot something. You need to go back to... Hold on a second. You'd go back to Wii Remote Controller. And make sure you select Wii Controller ME for your input method. And now you can play Dead Trigger. I am sorry that I forgot that because I am a stupid person. Now you can play Dead Trigger. You may need to reconnect your controller through Wii Controller app, because if you've been following this along exactly at the exact same time I have, then you just messed up along with me, so I am sorry about that. Make sure you select that. And I opened the wrong app. I am very tired right now, so I am being really stupid. And now you are playing Dead Trigger with a Wii Remote and Nunchuck. Apologize if this is all really laggy, because screencast whatever, it's not the best app in the world, and can get pretty laggy. And also, I'm not the greatest at this game because I just got it, because I've had a pretty crappy phone before this phone. But anyway, yeah, that's basically just how you do the Wiimote and Nunchuck controls for Dead Trigger. So, thanks for watching, and enjoy Dead Trigger.